Welcome back, guys, to my next PvP build for Lost FTC. I'm on my Magicka Nightblade this time with my ganker with another one hit build, but based on the vampire spammable Blood for Blood. Before I dive into the build, let's talk about the skill first. Blood for Blood skates on your missing health, has a damage bonus of 75%. The health cost with Vamp Stage 4 is at 1744 health. Our goal is to drop our HP as close as possible on this value, without dropping below of course, otherwise we would be not able to use the ability. So first step is we need to adapt our HP. I'm on a Khajiit, which has a HP bonus passive. I simply put out 1 point of the passive called Lunar Blessings out, and on top added 1 single point in HP. With this, I'm on at around 1.8k HP if I use Equilibrium 3 times in a row when I'm full life to drop my HP as close as possible on the Blood for Blood HP cost to gain the maximum damage of 75%. With 1.8k HP, I would say I'm at around 70% damage increase bonus. If you have questions about it, just type them down below. Quick talk about the sets. I'm using Core Riptide on the body. For 740 spell damage, we just need to drain our stamina at around 33%. Combined with War Maiden, almost 600 spell damage to magic damage abilities. And Balorg as monster set. On the back bar, just a random restoration stuff. I mainly use the critical repost stuff for extra crit resistance. Armor types, I'm on 5 light. Two medium. Full divines. Full max magicka glyphs. Full infused jewelry with spell damage. Two maces for extra penetration, numb and sharp. Poison flame damage enchant. And back bar. Just the restoration stuff in defending with the Berserker Glyph. Skills Camouflage Hunter, Concealed Weapon, just slotted for the extra 10% increased flat damage now. They reworked this stuff. When you leave Sneak, Invisibility, or Magic Expedition ends, while in combat, your damage done is increased by 10% for 5 seconds. That's why I always use a Light or Heavy Tech before I use Blood for Blood to gain the extra 10% flat damage bonus. Not always, but it works most of the time. They also decrease the movement speed when in sneak from 25% I think to just minor expedition, so 15%. Then our spammable Blood for Blood. Relentless Focus for the 10% extra crit damage just slotted. And they use Relentless Focus, the stamina morph, to drain my stamina while I'm in sneak with skills like Barb Trap or Camouflage Hunter are not possible, they will bring you out of stealth, but it works with Relentless Focus. Then Barb Trap, just slotted for the extra 3% spell damage, thanks to Slayer. Dawnbreaker, our ultimate, which I use as pre-buff for extra 300 spell damage, pretty nice. Bake Bar, Shoot Offering, Burst Heal, Rapid Regen, Hot, Race Against Time or Snare Removable from Age Expedition and Minor Force. Then Equilibrium, just to drain our HP. Shadow Disguise on the back bar. And again, Flawless Stormbreaker just slotted. So it's easier to pre-buff myself, I don't have to bar swap. But you can also put something else like a Restoration, Ultimate, Night Champion or Barrier for more Magicka Region. Race, like I said, Khajiit. Mainly for the crit damage bonus. Then Mundus, the Shadow for extra crit damage. 17% extra crit damage, insane with full divines. Ghastly Eyeballs buff food. Vamp Stage 4 to decrease the health cost as low as possible for Blood for Blood. Attribute points 63 Magicka and only 1 point in health. Potions, the normal spare power potions, or the detection potions. CPs, blue ones, Mastered Arm, Steady Aim, Backstabber and Fighting Finesse, red ones, Bastion, Rejuvenation, Celebrity and Bounce's Vitality. Let's talk about the rotation. As soon as you've spotted a target, try to stay line of sight to pre-buff yourself undetected. keep Race Against Time up, and start to drain your HP with 3 times Equilibrium if you're ready. Use Stormbreaker afterwards into Shadow Disguise, drain your stamina with Relentless Focus until around 30%-ish in combination with Shadow Disguise and Race Against Time. If you're in range, use a fully charged heavy attack into Blood for Blood and see a target. For some style points, it's even sometimes possible to run at a target without a heavy attack or a light attack in between. That's it with the build. Thanks for watching, have a nice day guys, and I'll see you hopefully in the next video. Peace.